No? Siberia bar. As we can see, we have more empty seats than full seats. That's okay, because it's only television and nobody will know unless I tell them, which I already did, so it's screwed. Anyway, if you haven't been here before, this is a Siberia bar. Voted in The Voice, the best bar in New York to throw up in. So if you feel comfortable, let's add to the reputation, kids. A few things before we get started with this whole mess tonight. I want to thank the performers who've come down tonight to perform for other performers. That was a very big thing that you did for yourself. Let me just throw this off on the side for a second. Two people here that I couldn't do this at all without. That's Mr. Jim Byrne over here and Mr. Bruce Friedman over there. Okay? They supplied the video and the handhelds and all the video equipment so that we can actually shoot this stuff, edit it, and get it on television and on the World Wide Web so people in New Zealand and Hong Kong and Singapore can see this. And I do get hits on my site from those places, so be ready for fan letters. Okay. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
We're going to be back with our first act after a short break, so don't go anywhere. We go in and when we go out. Otherwise, I have to use canned applause, which doesn't sound good. Anyway, our first act is a woman who's been on the show a few times with us, and she's been after me and after me that she's wanted to go up there and do a solo thing without her partner, because the comedy of Mike and Sue works as the comedy of Mike and Sue, and they always work together. Jim? You don't mind. Thank you. What are you doing, dental examination? Anyway, for her first solo performance anywhere, let's give a big round of applause to Miss Sue Kroll.
Now you know. Now you know why he won't let me do a solo act. Anyway, all kidding aside, I want to thank you all for being here tonight.
No!
What are you doing to me? Out! He is so impossible. Okay. Isn't it? He interrupts me. I can't stand this. Anyway, all kidding aside, I'm going to tell you this great story. It's about
everybody. When the moon hits you,
I will try again. Okay, and here's this woman. She's 58 years old, and she's going to go to her high school reunion. Now, let me try one more time.
All right, well, I'm sorry, Sue. That's about it. That's all the time
what?
We got for you.
What?
Sorry.
What?
I'm sorry. We're on a tight schedule. All right, we're going to have to take a short break, so don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back. Once a month?
Yes, tomorrow.
It's called tomorrow.
A night of 50 tits.
That's tomorrow?
Yes, it's 7 o'clock here, live at Siberia.
You better get done by 8 o'clock because when the Yankees play, everybody's going to go home.
I know. But we're going to show them
you?
Tits.
Anyway, Miss Lenna Conley, let's give her a hand.
Oh, you guys. Hi, you guys are so great. Oh, thanks. Listen, this is not my first time I've been on a live internet broadcast, you guys. Last time was in college when I needed to make some money. Yes, it was with a donkey, but who's counting, you know? Like the donkey show. Anyway, you guys, I don't know about you, but Jerry Garcia is here tonight, so I'm... How do you feel about Fish being your new rival? Yeah, well, what do you have to talk about? Not that I have an accent. I just talked to, hey, please the fifth. But anyway, you guys, how do you like my outfit today? I went to Mandy's. You guys know Mandy's? I don't know if the internet, it's a store for up-and-coming hookers. Yeah, which was my college life. And John knows all about it. Yeah, so, but anyway, yeah, I was feeling really young and pretty and like getting the little tie-dye shirts and the little jeans with the crisscrosses, you know, with showing some of the leg, even though it's winter, and my hooker jacket over there, ladies and gentlemen, here for my hooker jacket, strawberries, I got a man, yeah. And I was feeling all pretty, and some young sales thing, she called me the M word. Ma'am. That's like the cashier saying, here's your receipt, nobody wants to boink you. Ma'am. Yeah, it was pretty disappointing. But I don't know, it's not too bad being a ma'am, Jerry. Younger guys kind of dig me. I remind them of that babysitter they never got to do as a kid, right? Look at that young guy over there, he's guilty as sin. Yeah, pop popcorn, tie me up, whatever, right? Yeah, I dated a younger fellow. How many women here have dated somebody younger? Not diaper genie, but you know what I mean. I know Sue has, right? Yeah, that fox. Love you. Yeah, I dated somebody younger. He was 20, I was whatever. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but you know what? When you date somebody younger, you gotta be teacher. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think the girls are catching on, right? Tiger, tiger, where are you, tiger? Get off of me, get off of me, get off of me. Drop the Xbox. Sweetheart, let's go over this again. This is a neck, not corn on the cob. This is a breast. You can do a little more than give it a high five. Thank you, that was brilliant. You can't laugh. Thank you, and this is my Xbox. Notice the start button. Yes, yes. My little fellow is so cute. He says, you're older, you're kinky, you must have lots of sex toys. I'm like, honey, you are the sex toy. Anyway, you guys, I don't know. How many people here survived the blackout? Do you remember the blackout? It was black, let me tell you. I don't know. I have my mom here. I don't know what was more traumatic. You know what I'm saying? During the blackout. Well, let's face it, my mother drinks a lot because that's what alcoholics do. On her tombstone, she wants ripped. Yeah, so it's good to know. So mom was up there, you know, during the blackout, looking out my apartment. What's this? This is like a street fair. It's a blackout. But when I first heard the news, actually, I had to go over and get her. And I was wondering, blackout, what is mom up to now? Oh, wait a minute, it's a blackout, blackout. Thank you, brilliant. And you'll get it later. No, anyway, so mom was up there. But, you know, I live on the Upper West Side. Any Upper West Siders here of Manhattan?
Yeah.
Yeah, the Dominican Republic. And who knew in Spanish, blackout meant block party? We got it, they got the Jesus, we got the blackout, we got the blackout. They're all grilling, Jerry. They were grilling. I'm not gonna follow some event system or anything. It's like if my neighbors are grilling, that have the hibachis out, I know there's danger, you know what I'm saying? Another thing, I'm running in the New York City Marathon. Any marathon runners here? Yeah, I'm doing it to say that I'm running in the New York City Marathon. Yeah, that's really what, I have to run too, which is gonna be inconvenient. And gonna be a bitch. Yeah, I'm running in the marathon. But I have a running partner. She talks a lot, which wants to make me run faster. But you know what I'm talking about, don't you? Give me a drum roll and then. Yeah. Love it. No, but I was telling her about my life story, which really was knocked up, getting fired, knocked up, getting fired, which was really quite a theme. And then I realized I can sing to myself something very special, my own song about the fact I can never keep a job, and maybe you guys know somebody just like that. Jerry. Ready? Unemployable. That's what you are. Unemployable from near or far. That's right, darling. It's in. They won't hire you, cause every 6 months they wanna fire you. If you had a brother, he'd be unemployable too. Thanks, everybody. Hope you're employable. Have a great show. Here's the marvelous.
To introduce one comedian who's here very much in New York City, long time. Da. I hope you have much stuff practiced, mister. Don't forget switch to turn on microphone. It's just like in Russia, only it works. Anyway, a gentleman who's played just about every club in New York City and some clubs that aren't in New York City,
Mr. Craig Dourmashkin.
Song that gets on people's nerves, gets on people's nerves, gets on people's nerves. I know a song that gets on people's nerves, and this is how it goes. You get the idea. Yeah, my daughter taught me that song. It drove me crazy. I figured I'd share it with you. Thank you. Yeah, I've been divorced now for 10 years. I have a 13-year-old daughter. A lot of losers just like me. Thank you. Yeah, and I teach junior high school art in Flushing, Queens. My life sucks. Yeah, my daughter's 13. She loves that store, Claire's. You ever see that? It's similar to Mandy's, but before you get to Mandy's, you gotta go to Claire's first. Yeah, it's an all-girl accessory store. You know, where they have all the jewelry and the crap for teenage girls. And I take her there a lot because she's a great kid. You know, I realize after taking her there so many times, I'm the only man in the store. Yeah, all the other divorced dads are outside, you know, you think they're in the Gap. No, they're outside looking for Beaver. Yeah. Yeah, I'm inside helping her pick out earrings. Look, honey, they match your eyes. There's something wrong with that. Yeah. You know, I mean, does that make me gay? Anybody?
Yes!
Thank you, yeah. Because no one ever really went over the etiquette of what you do when you take your daughter to Claire's. And what you do is you give her 20 bucks, you tell her, I'll be back in an hour, I'm going out to look for Beaver. But you know, I really felt uncomfortable. And you know, I started milling around the store and I found a whole display of leather studded bracelets.
Yeah.
They have those there. Now I feel like a real man. Then I realized gay men wear those too. I was having dinner with my daughter the other night, and she knows I'm an artist and everything, of course. And she was very proud of her manicure that she gave herself. She says, Dad, what do you think? I said, honey, you know, the colors, you know, it's pretty good, but you went out of the lines a little bit. She said, Dad, you must be gay because straight men don't say things like that. Daddy's little girl. God. Now she's getting calls from boys. Thank you very much. Yeah, this kid calls up, at least I thought it was a kid, calls up, he says, hello, is Danielle there? I said, who's this? He says, this is Mike. Like he's proud of something. Thank you. So I said, Mike, you call back here looking for my daughter? I'm gonna sick my 7th grade special ed kids on you, Mike. You don't wanna deal with that. So I go back into my classroom the next day and make an announcement. Anybody want extra credit? It's an after school job and his name is Mike. And if you take him out, you pass the class. Oh, God. You know, my health hasn't been so great lately. I ended up in the... Thank you. Such a wonderful crowd. I ended up in the hospital a few times, and, you know, I had to have elbow surgery. I found out I have asthma. I'm losing my hair. I have a rash. I'm falling apart, okay? I mean, I leave layers of skin everywhere I go. People know where I've been. They're like, hey, Craig's been here. How do you know? Well, there's his elbow. Emergency rooms are really interesting, though. Very interesting places. Yes, thank you. You guys will clap at anything. Anyway, I'm lying there in the emergency room, and I got the fluids going, I got the monitors on me. All of a sudden, I have to take the most unbelievable piss you ever... They hand you this plastic thermos. You know, with that gooseneck. Yeah, like, that makes a difference. I don't know about you people in here, but I can't pee up. I've tried, it just doesn't work. And nurses take an oath. They do. Yeah. They take an oath to help people in situations like this. I mean, they put the, and they're very proud of this. They put the gloves on, they give you privacy, they help you point things in the right direction. But what if you have a male nurse named Bruno? What do you do then? First Claire's name is, I don't know. And doctors, doctors are great people. I mean, I love my doctor, you know, really. I mean, he's a great guy. He gives me medication for things I don't even need. Yeah. Mike, you're looking a little good. Mike's looking very good. A little blue, but. Yeah. And you know, and what is it with doctors though? I mean, they as soon as they enter the environment of a hospital, they enter this stupid question mode. I never could understand. They admit me into the hospital. I'm lying there in my room. This doctor comes in, says, "So, what brings you here?" "An ambulance." So I said to my doctor, I says, "You know something, doc? You know something? The next time I have that gut-wrenching, life-threatening, burning sensation pain in my chest, I'm gonna take a bus." But not any old, and not on any old bus. No. I'm gonna take the kind of bus that you have to wait around for a really long time. That's right, the express bus. Yeah. My name is Craig Dourmashkin. You guys have been great. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Philadelphia, and parts unknown. I heard these guys in sound check, and they're gonna blow you away. Harmonies and everything, Stewkey's Naz.
Thank you.
He at first didn't see me there.
He said the flying got him high.
I at first said I didn't care.
I can wait till my time comes around.
With my feet on the ground, when I get my
plane.
I don't think trains are here to stay.
I don't like taxis anymore.
I don't think buses. is all the way.
And as Wilbur and Arbor said,
I think cycling's dead when I get my way. When I get my way. When I get my
way. Get my pay. When I get my.